Hi. What is it that you do naturally when you're encountered with unpleasant, ambiguous situations? Unless you're in complete control of your mind, you tend to do one of the things, either fight or flight. Take a flight, I mean. I have used both these responses in my life. I fight with my friends and almost always take a flight when I'm confronted by dad, obviously. But over the years, I have learned and practiced one tool that helped me get over my anxiety, my fears, my negative thoughts and feelings, and works wonderfully even today. That tool is self-talk, and today I want to share my story on how I help myself with positive self-talk. Let's get started. Hey there, my name is Aparna. I'm a certified coach. Every week, I bring to you tips, tricks, tools, and hacks that can help you upskill your life. And if this sounds interesting to you, do consider subscribing to my channel. And while you're there, do not forget to press the bell icon so you're notified every week when I post a new video. And if you're watching this on Facebook, do not forget to like my page. You may or may not know, but you're talking to yourself all the time. Self-talk is basically our inner voice that gives us a running commentary. Even now, if this commentary is positive, then our lives are in a path to happiness. Negative rumination, though, would lead us to disaster. Of many difficult situations I've been in, positive self-talk has helped me 99% of the time. So it's powerful. But it never begins with positive self-talk, you know? And there's a science behind it. I almost always begin with negative self-talk. And then I realize, oh my God, what am I doing to myself? And deliberately try to come out of that situation. I use a three-step approach. The first one is that I started to listen to my conversations. I became aware. I took notes. I understood the type of talk that naturally comes to me and what that is doing to me. You know, you probably will relate to me when I say that when you think of doom and gloom, especially when you're in that negative self-talk mode, you tend to become more irritable. At least I did. I became irritable, frustrated, and that impacted my behavior, which in turn impacts everyone around me, quite like a domino effect. When you realize what is happening to you, only then you will do something about it, right? So once I started listening to my conversations, then the second step is to challenge them. I ask myself, is there any evidence to what I'm thinking? And most importantly, do I believe or agree 100% with it? Believe me when I say that I create some of the most ridiculous conversations. And when I ask myself these questions, whether I believe in them, the answer is almost always no. I'm sure you go through it as well. Although we tend to create self-talk, rarely do we believe what we tell ourselves. And this happens when you challenge those conversations. So the obvious next step is to change my conversations. How do you do that? I looked at all the things that are positive within me and around me. Gratitude helps. And then I quite literally change the sentences. So instead of thinking, I'll never be able to get over this, I started replacing it with, what can I do to get over this? I've already spoken in detail on how you convert your negative self-talk into positive in a different video, and I will share the link to it in the description below. That's it. All the three steps that I follow are simple and easy to do as long as you have an intention to get over what you're feeling, those anxious thoughts. But therein lies a danger. If you are sucked too much into negative rumination, you will not even know what you're telling yourself. This is a time when you reach out to a friend or a coach who can help you understand or make you aware of the kind of conversations you're having. If you need any such help, do contact me. My details are given in the description below. That's it from me. If you find this video resourceful, do hit a like button and share it with those who you think need to hear this. And I'll see you next week with another topic. Until then, take good care of yourself. Bye.